Hello and welcome at this series about Sitecore Basics. In this video we're going to look at component properties. So the best way to start looking at component properties is to go to the Experience Editor, which I have opened here, and to select a component. In this example I have an image component and I can look at the component properties by clicking on the More button in the Component Toolbox and choose the Edit Component Properties option. This pop-up will appear and it gives me some options to configure how this component will behave. Now the options that you will see here can differ from the options that you will see on your components because I am using the Sitecore Experience Accelerator framework, which contains a bunch of default components with a bunch of default properties. And in your situation, it can be different. So don't look for exactly the same things. But some basic settings that almost any component have is the placeholder where the component is placed on, the data source for the content and an ID. And from here, you will have context-based settings. Now, something that is always available in SXA is the grid settings. So what I can do here is change how this component behaves on the responsive grid. So I'm not going to explain this for now, but I'm just changing it to let you understand what component properties can do. I change it to 3 to make it a little bit smaller. And as you can see, I have a lot of other options here, which we will leave for now. And I can click OK. And as you can see, the behavior of this component has now changed. So it's more about the behavior rather than about the content. I'm going to switch to another tab. And in here I have, for example, the main navigation. So let's go to More and Edit Component Properties. And another example of what you can do with component properties is for this specific component, setting how the navigation should behave. So I can select the top level navigation. It's now set to 1, which means that anything directly beneath the home page will be listed here. But I can set it to 2, click OK, and then it will do something like this. So it influences some logic behind this component. And this is the way you can use component properties to influence the behavior. Now there is another way of accessing these component properties, and they are similar in the Content Editor and the Experience Editor. So from here I can go to Presentation, to go to Details, and I can go to Final Layout. We will explain this in another video, and in here I can click on a component and you will see that I have exactly the same properties. So let's cancel that. And when I switch to the Content Editor, I can go to the home page here. And I have also the Presentation tab here. I can go to Details on the Layout section. And in the Final Layout, I can click on the Rich Text, for example. And I can change the component properties as well. But the disadvantage of this way is that you don't directly see the behavior or the changes that you have made. And you will be able to see them when working in the Experience Editor.